Now, is it audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks. Now we'll learn about the virtual lab. What is the concept of virtual lab? Have you learned about that in any other class? Today is the first day. I hope you might have not listened about the virtual lab. So I will make you clear what is the concept of virtual lab. Okay. So I will share this slide. Simply one can go to Google. Okay. Right here, virtual lab. Right here, virtual lab. Is my screen visible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Then click on virtual lab. This you will be able to see this portal, Ministry of Education under National Mission on Education through ICT. So such a ICT content has been created by the Ministry of Education through various IITs. So that we are using here for learning purpose. So here are the different engineering disciplines are there. We will study through our subjects. So we'll click on civil engineering. You can also do at your own level, but here we will explain it. Okay. Now here there are the different subjects: concrete structure lab, transportation engineering lab, environmental engineering lab 1, 2. Now you have studied environmental engineering 1, means water supply engineering. So that's why in this semester we will go to learn the virtual lab of environmental engineering 1. So what is the purpose behind taking this sessions? These sessions, I will clear you. So because of COVID-19, we failed to perform the experiments in laboratory. And it should not happen like this. You will not understand forever this. So we tried at our level to show you experiments by through camera and all those activities, but still it may not be that much competent. And though it has happened, so these procedures are very nicely explained. So we have decided to go with a virtual lab concept. So what is that virtual lab concept? I hope you understood. Okay. Now I'm taking environmental engineering 1 for you. As you have studied water supply engineering in a second year, and now you are in a third year. So path you understood how to go to that virtual lab for that particular subject. Okay. Now here under environmental engineering 1, there are the list of experiments they have provided. So first experiment is the determination of total solid, total dissolved solid, total suspended solids in water. Then second one is the determination of alkalinity in water, determination of hardness in water, determination of chloride in water, determination of total iron in water, and determination of pH, and determination of biological oxygen demand. These are the experiments listed over here, and that you might have performed, you might have seen a demonstration by your faculty member, how they are performing these experiments in the laboratory, okay, in the last semester. So that will be kind of revision. And I personally would like to suggest you to pay attention properly, because this way is not going to give you experience of hands-on, but also for a competitive examination, though it is a GATE, though it is a MPSC or whatever may be there. So many of the questions are coming means 2-3 questions at least will be there from the experimental side. So how experimental side? So specific parameter, you know, the various parameters of water, physical parameter, chemical parameter, and biological parameter. Okay. So under each parameter, how to test that you have learned. Okay. Now for testing purpose, what is the titrant? What is the indicator? And that way questions are there usually. And the last one important question on this basis is, what is the standard limit, disposal standard limit, or the drinking water supply standard limit as per the IS code? So these three types of questions will be clear with this virtual lab. Okay, so that's why I will request everybody to pay attention properly in this. Okay, now the determination of first experiment in today's session, actually your lecture is going will be getting end up on 4:15, and I also I would have been continued for some more time because I know that you people are very interested in such activities, but I will try for 15 minutes more because I have another activity. That is, you know that you will be participant for that Innovation Council activity. So because of that, we'll not complete experiment today, but definitely in the next lecture, we will complete it properly. So determination of total solid, total dissolved solid, and total suspended solids. That experiment I will take first, okay? So the aim of experiment is given here is to determine the total solids, total dissolved solids, total suspended solids, volatile suspended solids, and fixed solids. So I will give you a background about solids first. You have already learned, but kind of revision will be there. Some of you may be remembering that, some of you may not be. Okay, solids, what are the different types of solids present into water? Basically, it is classified into three. First one, suspended solid, second one, dissolved solid, and third one, colloidal solids. Under suspended solids, some of the solids are in a suspension form at the surface. Some may be able to settle down at the bottom. Means some may be floating, some may be settleable under suspended solids. Then we'll go to the next, that is dissolved solids. Dissolved solids. Such solids will not change the physical properties of water. These will change the chemical properties of water. And because these types of solids are in a dissolved form in a water. Are you getting? Then the third one parameter is the colloidal solids. What about colloidal solids? The colloidal solids are always in a motion. They are always in a motion, keep on moving from one place to another place in a water. Why it happens? Because there is a these particles are usually charged particles. So because of charge, they are always in a motion. Okay. So this way, there are the fundamentally three types of solids present in water. Now, then determination of total solid, dissolved solid, and total suspended solids we are going to perform over here. Total solid is the summation of total dissolved solids, total suspended solids, volatile solids, and fixed solids. Volatile solids and fixed solids are usually less in number. Very few, negligible compound is present, but dissolved solid and suspended solids quantum is more. So that's why usually we in the laboratory, we perform experiment to determine the total dissolved solids and total suspended solids. Summation of total dissolved solids and total suspended solid is the total solids. Okay. So that is the background of this solids. Okay. Now we want to determine. So further, one more important fact I will tell you. Pay attention, please. Total dissolved solids. If it is in a dissolved form, and if I will filter it out through something, whether it will pass along with water or it will remain on the particular that filtrate. Can anybody? I have taken a cloth and I will take a sample of water, bottle of water, and I will pour into that cloth. So whether it will pass, the dissolved solids will pass through it, or dissolved solids will retain on that cloth. Let me know.
Pass through it.
Vaibhavi had given answer that it will pass through it. Yeah, definitely. Likewise, if suspended solids are there, whether these suspended solids will pass through that cloth or it will retain on the cloth? Suspended solids, I am talking. You can answer through or you can unmute yourself. Yes, someone spoken. Yeah, it will retain on the cloth. Uday has answered. You are correct, Uday. Okay, so this way we are going to perform. This fundamental, keep it in your mind, then we'll proceed. So theory, whatever I have explained, that is written in this format. So we'll not go by this theory. So simply, so whenever there are the experiments, in each experiment, they have kept a pretest. So we will see the pretest first. We will solve the pretest and then we'll proceed to the next part, procedure part. So pretest, in the pretest, first question is, find suspended solids in water. Fine suspended solids in water is removed by screening, skimming, sedimentation, filtration. Anyone can answer? I will note your answer. I will not answer. Fine suspended solids in water is removed by screening, skimming, sedimentation, filtration. Let it be wrong. Answer. Yes, someone answered, I received an answer from one student, that is option D, filtration, given by, answer is given by Uday. Anybody else? Everybody should answer. I should think whose answer I should take. And in that case, I will take judgment, may, who had given multiple poll. Yeah, Gauri and Nikita had answered that. Project also answered option C, sedimentation. So out of four, I have received three answers as option C. I will go with option C. Okay, let us check at the end. No worry. Mansi also answered option C. Okay, thank you guys. We'll go to the second question. Total suspended solids are mostly responsible for. Second question. Vaibhav, we go to second question now. Second question is, total suspended solids are mostly responsible for color, turbidity, odor, taste. Anyone can answer now? Total suspended solids are mostly responsible for. Total suspended solids are mostly responsible for. I should reach answers. For question one, everybody answered. Most of the students answered. Yes, speak out, fast. Yes, I received an answer from Vaibhavi, option B, turbidity. Priyanka, option B. Gauri also answered option B. Rutuja answered option B. Mansi answered option B. Then Rajnandini answered B. Okay, I will go with the answer B. Now my next question to all of you guys. Whether in this class only girls are there? Except Uday, only girls are there in this class? No, na? Boys are also there in this class? Let me check. Or whether I have placed my invitation link only for the girls or not, for boys also. Let me check. Total suspended solids. Boys are also there. Then why don't you answering? Yeah, Uday only answering. Yeah, I will go with you guys. Answer option B. Okay. We'll put the answer option B. Then next, the chemical substance used in the desiccator is. What is this desiccator? You may not be knowing the concept of desiccator. I will show you. You can see here the picture of desiccator. Okay. This is a desiccator. You can see here. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Desiccator purpose. What is the purpose of desiccator usually? We are using it for cooling purpose. Means something if we have used for boiling or the evaporation purpose or for the drying purpose in the oven, and after removing from the oven, I'm supposed to get it before going to wet, note down the wet, noting the weight of that particular material, I should allow to cool that particular sample material thing, whatever used. Okay. Then if we are cooling it in an open atmosphere, it may absorb the atmospheric moisture, and that effect of atmospheric moisture may absorb in the weight of that particular thing. So to avoid that, we can keep it into the desiccator for cooling purpose, and then it will not allow to absorb the moisture of the surrounding, and hence accuracy of the result will be maintained. Okay, so that's why this desiccator is being used. So I will go back to virtual lab, and I will read the question once again. The chemical substance sorry okay, the chemical substance used in the desiccator is calcium carbonate, sodium chloride, sodium hydroxide, calcium chloride. Received answer from one student that Uday had answered option A, calcium carbonate. Nikita answered option D, Mansi, Rutuja. Many girls have answered, Rajnandini, Poonam, everybody answered that option D. So majority of answer is option D. So I will go with option D. Okay, calcium chloride. Okay, then next one, this question level of this question is very good actually, and you can use these questions for preparation of your exams also, competitive examinations also. So I'm going to provide you these questions in the soft form, but still you can learn over here. Always the total suspended solids value will be less than total dissolved solids, greater than total dissolved solids, less than total solids, greater than total solids. Yes, answer received from Rajnandini, Tejashree, Uday, option C. Okay, I will go with the option C, less than total solids. Simple logic is there. Total, always the total suspended solids value will be less than total solids, because total solid is the summation of total suspended solids plus total dissolved solids plus fixed solids plus volatile solids, etc., etc. Is it? So all of you has Sudarshan also answered, then Priyanka. Okay. So many of you have answered option C. So I have noted you down your answer as a option C. Now the last question of this pre-test is high total dissolved solids indicates lower level of hardness. True or false? High total dissolved solids indicates lower level of hardness. True or false? Received 3-4 answers. Uday, Tejasree, then Rajanandini, Vaibhavi, Kshitija, Poonam, Sudarshan, Mansi, Snehal. So all of you, Shrikant, Prajakta, all of you have answered option B. So I will click on option B, that is fall. So I will submit the quiz and will check the answer. Okay. Submit the quiz. Oh, great. We all have achieved the 5 out of 5. All questions are correct. Very nice. You are using your logic correctly. So we are getting the correct answers. Very nice. 5 out of 5. Okay. So this way we have performed the pre-test usually. Okay. Now the next step we can proceed. Okay, next step is the procedure. Okay, in the procedure here, we are clear with the aim. Okay, objective is to determine the total solid, total dissolved solid, total suspended solids, total volatile solids and fixed solids, fixed suspended solids in the given water supply sample. Okay, what are the different apparatus required? Okay, so the first one is the weighing balance. Very important apparatus required in this experiment is the weighing balance. Second is required a putrescible plate, or we can say it is the what it is known as putrescible plate itself, we can say. Then next one is the crucible. Then this one is the filter papers through which we can filter the paper water. Okay, and this is the filter arrangement. Okay, filtering arrangement. So this is known as the petri dish. Sorry, the name is given over here. This is name is the petri dish. Okay, so this is a crucible. This is a filter paper. Okay, and this is the membrane filter holder. Okay, then oven is required for this. Vacuum pump is required. Beaker is required. Desiccator and pipette is required. Okay, so this is demonstrated through a simulation by these IITians, and then we can see the simulation. So it may not complete today, but we can just start it and then let it be, end up to the 40 minutes, whatever is getting time now. Okay, so here you can see this is the requirement simulation. So they will show you how to handle all these equipments. Many of the times in a environmental engineering laboratory, we are not knowing how to handle these particular instruments or the equipments, apparatus. So it can be said very properly. So total suspended solids. Now this is a water sample, and they are asking me to open the tab, keep it aside, then take the pipette. This is known as the pipette. Okay, pipette is having a balloon which can be pressed before entering, putting it into the water sample. Now I can release that balloon, so it will pump the water, and then if I will release that pressure, it will drop the sample into the particular beaker where we want. Now I will close this water sample bottle. Okay, then proceed to the next. Now this is the weighing balance. Okay, first of all, I need to put it on. So on button pressed by me. Then this is a crucible. So for performing this experiment, crucible water filter is required. Crucible and water filters wet, empty wet first we have to take, and then perform experiments, and along with that residues, we can take the final wet. So empty wet can be assumed as of initial wet, and then another final wet will be along with the residues. So I will take that crucible, and this is an empty crucible, clean and clear, swachh, without any moisture content, without any dust particles. So I will wait, note down the wait. Okay, noted down wait. You also can note down some calculative corrections may be there in the software, but still we will learn the procedure. Okay, weight of the empty crucible is noted down 38.206 gram. Okay, there is very importance to this unit in the environmental engineering. So noted down the weight. Now it is asking me to remove. I have removed it aside. Now it is removed, and still here it is showing the weight as a 0.0. What is it showing? It is showing 0.022 as a weight. If there is nothing, how come it is showing weight? It should not show the any weight. That is the error. That is the error of that weighing machine. So that's why what you need to do, you need to press the button there before you go to use for next purpose. And I have pressed the button there, and now it is showing 0.0. That error has been removed. Now I will take that petri dish and will note down the weight. Weight of the empty petri dish is noted down 16.415. Okay. Now, whether petri dish is required for us or not, it is not required. Which weight is required? We need the weight of filter paper, is it? But empty filter paper taking weight is difficult. So that's why as a supporting material, we have taken a petri dish. Okay, so that's why, because we don't want to have the weight of petri dish, I will put the button tear. So it will become zero. It has become a zero. Then you can take the filter paper and put it into that petri dish and then note down weight of ashless filter paper separately as 0.38216 gram. Okay, have you noted down? You can also note down. Okay, so this is the weight of filter paper. Okay, and this is the weight of empty petri dish. Now summation of these two will be the weight of petri dish plus ash filter. If we have not teared and kept the filter paper as it is here, we would have not been getting the weight of filter paper separately. So that's why we have pressed the button tear and placed into the same petri dish the filter paper, and then summation of these two can give us the total weight of petri dish and filter paper. Okay, now they are asking me to remove it. Okay, I will remove it. Oh, great. There is a question. The TDS present in water are one of the leading causes of turbidity and sediments in drinking water. Okay, the TDS present in water are one of the leading causes of turbidity and sediments in water. True or false? What is this? The TDS present in water are one of the leading causes of turbidity and sediments in drinking water. I have received answer from someone, that is Vaibhavi has answered that of true. I will try. So true, wrong answer. Answer is actually we need to read this question properly because it is getting disappeared immediately and we have no provision to go back to that questions. Okay, hence after we will take care. Okay, now the next one. So this arrangement for filtration purpose is provided over here. I will remove the top. Okay, then I will put this filter paper on this mesh and then again I will put the cap over here. And then I will connect the vacuum filter vacuum pump. Why we need to connect the vacuum pump? Because if there is a critical filtration, at that time it should suck entire water at the bottom. It should not happen like thodo pani varti rahile, thodo pani filter zalele. It should not happen. So that's why we need to suck it properly. Okay. Now I will connect that, as it is asking me to connect the vacuum pump. I will connect the vacuum pump. And then I will switch on the button. Very systematic instructions are being given here. Okay. Then the measured sample, we have taken a sample as a 100 ml sample measured with the help of pipette and taken into the beaker. So I will drop that sample into this pot. So it will start pumping, filtering out. Immediately it will be get filtered out because vacuum pump is connected. Okay. Now I will put off the vacuum pump. And we'll disconnect the vacuum pump from this. Okay. This way, now filtration is done. Okay. Last 3 minutes are remain. And I have another session, which will be scheduled, which is scheduled through my login itself. And I am the coordinator of that IIC activity. So I have to stop. I need to stop your lecture. But I assure you, in the next lecture, I will make sure that we will complete this experiment once again from the start, but little faster. Will it be fine, guys? Will it be fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we'll see the remaining part in the next lecture. So just wait for a few minutes. I will log in from my mobile and will take the screenshot as your attendance and then... Okay guys, I have noted down your attendance. I will use this another account. Okay, fine. I have noted down your attendance. So we'll meet in the next lecture. So timing, I will declare this session is over. Thank you. Join for the next session arranged by me under the Institutions Innovation Council. That is very good sessions going on. Morning also we had one session. You also requested to join at 5 o'clock for that session. Either Facebook link will be shared with you or Zoom link will be provided with you. Whatever may be there, you can join there. Okay, please. Thank you.